Real quick. Nice easy one.
Professor, I did it!
God damn it.
The princess is most happy to see you.
But she's actually in another castle.
Oh no.
Because of course she is. She's being held
that's
by
amazing.
Some...
He really made it to the princess.
He's being... Don't you know, the princess is being held by another turtle with a spiky shell. It seems to be a bit yellow.
Dragon.
And he really stole the princess just because he wants to give his kids its proper mother.
Mm-hmm. He's actually a really good dad. Or he tries to be, anyway.
He's a good dad, but he's not a great guy.
No.
At last, the crying stops.
You must remember to be brave, even when you feel afraid. Sometimes even I feel scared if I'm alone. It's when the voices start talking to me.
I keep trying to lose him, but he keeps coming back.
I believe that if you're with someone you care about, you can overcome any fear.
He's not wrong.
True.
Got it. Thanks. From now on, I'll take care of Petal.
I really don't mind one way or the other. But I do wish you'd stop your crying.
Yep. It's because of this bald cut. Bowl cut.
Damn. Hard to feel brave with the bowl
cut. I cry about that too.
That. Money.
It's a bell.
Chimney.
Chim 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 chim
Leighton's kind of just there. I mean, I throw in the stuff about Luke just to spice him up because Leighton's so dull.
Yeah, that's true.
He is.
So, I mean, his face is Phoenix made out of wood.
Phoenix Wright. I love Phoenix Wright. He's so good. I love Phoenix Wright.
All right, well, so, who wants?
No, I need to go. I need to go cook. I really do.
All right,
you go cook.
Fuck out of here.
Let go get food.
See you, Con.
Go get food.
No.
I said go get food.
Go get food.
Go get food.
Why am I? This is what happens when I don't eat.
Just the Con.
Go get food.
I mean, yeah, here.
See that? Whack this guy's
pee-pee.
Bailiff, whack his pee-pee.
You killed him. He's gone.
He's dead.
Perfect timing for kicking him out of here.
Hey, I need to move.
Fuck here, boy. He's here.
Phoenix does look really weird, Ash.
So,
the captain over.
Captain or Marco?
I was moving captain over on my ship.
Professor Layton.
Who wants to pick
who
up
Layton? Who wants to be Professor Layton?
I'm Luke, and I'm always with Professor Layton. So if you pick,
I can be Professor Layton. It doesn't
pick
matter.
Professor Layton, you're gonna be interacting with me a bit.
Okay.
So it's Marco.
Marco is now Layton. Got it.
Okay, so, Layton.
All right.
Phoenix time. No, I didn't.
Well,
well, I won't read that then. Oh wait, no, this is the voiced part.
Yeah,
never mind. Mm-hmm. I forgot this was the voiced part.
Oh, he can take a pounding.
He's giving the pounding, Marco.
Ah!
Oh my gosh, Layton! Oh my god!
Layton!
All I can picture with like the noise in the background.
He has been taken over by Marco.
That's true.
No, literally the frame he switches to Marco. The frame. Mr. Wright, these gentlemen are
customers. They're my friends. Oh, really? No money, no bread.
Hey, Maya! Welcome home.
Hello, Maya. Where's Aunt Patty? The boss? She's gone to the market. She should be back at any time now.
Oh yeah, it was Maya last time, wasn't I? Nick here.
He didn't realize mm-hmm. the customers. Do you want to keep that or because yeah, Zena, you want to pick that up? You don't haven't done too much, Zena.
I mean, I could.
Okay.
It's up to you.
Up to you. I'll be Professor Layton.
Yeah, or we could give it to Captain. We can give Maya to Captain.
Captain?
Right, you.
Captain?
Maya Mayor.
Captain?
What?
You want to be Maya?
You want to be Maya?
Sure.
Okay.
All right.
With also, Zena, with how this is going, this does make me really want to play Danganronpa with all you guys.
Yes. Danganronpa.
Ayo indeed, Circuit. Ayo indeed.
We'd be able to just go, okay, I pick this character,
exactly.
This character.
There's not too many characters in it. Danganronpa? Yes, Danganronpa. Mm-hmm. I think
I've never played them, but it would be interesting.
Think like Phoenix Wright type thing.
You know, I like I said, I'm aware of them. I avoided them just because they seemed
his
like just visual
Herschel?
Novels
no
to me.
No wonder he goes by Professor Layton.
Nice to meet you. Herschel.
Who's the assistant here? Phoenix Wright, pleased to meet you. How come I'm the assistant? That's my favorite frame of Phoenix is the sweating. That's my favorite one.
Mr. Phoenix Wright and Miss Maya Fey. Somehow not quite the kind of names I'd expect to hear around here. Have you both been working here long? Luke, don't touch that.
But I wanted a piece of bread.
I'm stealing stuff.
You don't get to eat. You know the rules.
Yep. Must be going on 5 years now. Isn't that right? Espella? Is that how you say her name?
Very nice. Espella. Espella Cantabella.
Also, it makes the most sense for Mare to have us because Espella is here as well. So now all
very,
five
very
of us
nice
have a character.
Thing.
Yay!
Yes. I suppose it must be. Captain?
Oh,
say, you know what? Seeing as you're both friends of Espella, I think we can give you guys a little something on the house, of course.
Food?
And then you pay me $20 afterwards.
Wow, really? Also, do I know you from Marvel vs. Capcom?
And into the oven you go.
Why not? I actually just took some freshly baked walnut bread out of the oven, so... Fuck you, walnut!
That's what happened.
Walnut dead.
Walnut took a pounding from Phoenix and got put in the oven.
There's no way that this is scripted. This is scripted. There's no way.
Xena went and edited the script just for this.
Just for this. That is
everybody
hilarious.
In chat is like, hey, yo!
Babe's laughing their ass off.
Guys. Oh, well, it's dead, Walnut dead.
Like Marco said, Walnut got pounded by Phoenix and then put in the oven.
Did he take you out to dinner first, Walnut? Or
no,
was it
he
just...
didn't.
Oh, he is the dinner, don't you know? Walnut bread is there to raise your appetites.
R.I.P. Walnut, we do you well. Eat the walnut bread.
It wasn't.
That walnut goes and cries in a corner for the rest of the stream.
No.
Do your lines if you're gonna cry.
I'm sorry, I was doing a bit on my shirt with my model.
No one was expecting the walnut fanfic today, Ashes. No one was.
My God.
I was expecting it.
No, you know what's actually the funniest part about this? Walnut I was talking about before how much I love Phoenix Wright.
Well, you turned it off now.
It comes full circle.
He's
oh,
you love me, all right.
No. When they say put a bun in the oven, that's not what they mean.
Oh, good heavens. I do not like. I do not like this new meta. No, we
this
are
is
not.
Absolutely true.
We are not getting into this. We are.
Yes,
moving
we
on.
Are.
Walnut needs to rebrand now.
Yes, Walnut loves you, Ash. Walnut loves you, Yang.
I am going to spill my water. I need to put it down.
So, Spade, this part of the stream is Walnut got pounded by Phoenix and turned into bread, then put in the oven, and now he's cooking.
Circuit Walnut has been canonically cooked.
New lore. Walnut's been cooked. He's dead.
I can't wait to see this highlight of this stream. God.
Quick, somebody go back and clip that. That's great.
Don't clip it. Highlight it. Yes. Highlight it. It's not going to be long enough.
It's too late to clip it. He's going to have to highlight it.
Hang on. No, I'll just write this down so I can get it later.
Imagining that, like, for whatever reason now, it's another reason why the Evoli have been cooked in a game.
No!
Damn.
Oh, damn.
Yeah,
no
so
wonder they're being
hunted. I have it written down.
So what you're saying is that while it's tasty?
Yes.
Oh, God.
I just hydrated.
I almost mocked saying that almost made me spit out my water.
There's a reason, I guess. Now we know why the Evoli have been poached.
It's all because of Phoenix Wright.
Yep.
They made the walnut bread. Now they want more.
No, I might edit this part. I've been trying to find new things to edit. I might edit it. We'll see.
Please do, because this is great.
You can use that face you laughed at before.
You could use the editing face.
Alright, I'll read my line. Core. So, this, what the great smell it is, I bet it's delicious.
I bet so. Somebody take a bite. If you think the scent's good, you should try tasting it.
Can
you
we
too,
don't.
Mr. Look, it's so good. It'll knock your hat right off.
Oh, no.
Oh,
the game audio has
gone
all crunchy, Xena.
It has, unfortunately.
It'll fix.
Yeah,
it'll fix itself, but in case anybody was wondering, that's where the nightmares come.
How about now?
There we go.
That's
perfect.
Much better.
Muckle?
Thanks, Linner. Thanks.
Yeet.
Muckle.
Oh, right. Sorry.
I forgot I was late in this time. I'd be delighted to. That's most kind of you.
Take that! Objection!
You didn't let him in your line, Xena.
Our bread uses only the finest walnuts.
It's the gift that keeps on giving, isn't it?
Yeah, it is the gift that keeps on giving. Well, so you're that fine that he just pounds you and then just puts you in the
cup. Oh, he's trying to get everyone to taste walnut.
Oh, good heavens.
Yeah, we're just gonna have to have a walnut bread party now.
I was literally just saying, if I edit this, it's probably only gonna be like a couple of minutes, but now I'm sure it's gonna go up for much longer.
This is great. This is great.
Yes, Circuit, we will archive the entire world.
What is it?
Emotional damage.
Jesus Christ. Which bloggers is Phoenix Wright going to talk about walnuts?
How much longer is Phoenix going to expound on the virtues?
Taking a
nap. How many times do I got to tell you, Nick, you're supposed to say, here's your order.
That's right. I forgot. I don't know why, but I just get the urge to point and shout like that sometimes.
Fair.
You can't keep shouting at the customers like that. The boss will be all over you like butter on toast.
Hey,
or walnut on toast.
Walnut on toast.
You should have used the spray bottle going bad.
Oh, wait, hold on. Wait. How dare you yell and point at customers like that?
Ugh.
That's all the water running down his face. That Baker, he's quite a character. He keeps talking about walnuts specifically. I don't know what that's about. Isn't he a professor?
Nuts.
He must be a big fan of nuts.
Especially
the finest walnuts.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, indeed. There's something curious about the both of them. I can't put my finger on it. They both seem somehow out of place in this world. Almost
and we
as
don't.
If they were transmigrated. Most intriguing.
The last thing I remember seeing is a giant truck barreling towards me.
Truckman strikes again.
Sorry. Truckoon isn't in the game.
Truckoon is in another castle?
Not Truckoon.
Truckoon is clearly in another castle, guys.
Anyway, my room is upstairs. We can get there from behind the counter. Feel free to take something to eat.
Not
oh
Luke.
My god. Oh my god.
What was that?
Sorry,
your motherfuckers took all the precious walnut bread. He wasn't pounding it yet.
Sorry, Chet, there was a mosquito that flew by. I'm sorry about that.
There. You sounded.
That's why you're in the bread, walnut. Like that's why you're in the bread.
It sounded like just a.
Yeah, all I heard was a shriek. That's all I heard.
My poor mic must have cut out. It's the same with the Bracken in the fucking Lethal Company.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you mean nice. Like right if you get surprised by a turret as well?
I have.
I need a new boom arm for my mic.
I have tears in my eyes.
Sir.
What's wrong?
Somebody took all the love of the bread.
No, Luke's not allowed to eat. Everyone else can take food.
He seems to be upset about something. It's you, isn't it, child?
Get in the oven, child.
Child, in the oven, now.
It's time to make some lukewarm bread.
Ah, yes.
Marco?
I already read the line.
She did.
Let's ask her if there's anything we can do to help.
Like solve a puzzle.
Right you are, Professor.
Get in the oven, child.
Phoenix of Wright looks so off-putting.
So hot. This is where bread is baked, huh? No.
Yeah, that precious walnut bread.
Damn it.
Lean in a little bit further. Yes, a little bit more.
Hey!
Nice. Nice. Aw.
And how's that child in the oven?
Phoenix looks off-putting. He looks so off-putting.
He's got resting warrior face. It's that resting warrior face. What else can we do?
True.
Yep.
What's the matter, Miss Faye?
It's these loaves of bread. And after I arranged them all so nicely, too, the fucking child knocked them over.
Fuck. Luke.
No. We're moving on. You don't need to read that line.
Everything. Why did you have to pound the walnut bread so hard?
Moving on.
I was only kneading the dough.
No.
You needed to pound it that hard.
What am I going to do? I have to fix this before boss gets back.
That's most unfortunate. Perhaps we can lend you a helping hand. I do have a child servant.
Really? Thanks a lot. You'd be doing the biggest favor in the world. Teach him how not to pound the walnut bread as hard.
No.
You could try to show a little straight sometimes, you know?
Says the man that was pounding the walnut.
Stop.
I didn't hear you complaining.
Not at all. Helping those in need is the duty of any true gentleman. Get to it, Luke.
Yeah.
Not only that, but if we chip in to help, as we'll soon have... Wait. We'll soon have it all figured out. And you guys will owe us money.
Totally, we should all help each other out in the times of need, right?
Now, about that $20.
Just so
about that $20.
The $20.
I don't see any walnuts.
Yeah, where's the walnuts?
I'm glad there's no walnut bread, to be honest.
You know, it was because he pounded it too hard. That's what it was.
That's true.
Jesus Christ.
He's still in the oven getting all hot.
Oh my god.
Don't you know? I could say it's a little steamy in there.
Oh my god.
It went from the pounding to the hot and fiery patch.
My god.
Are you dying, Errol?
Imagine seeing just walnut, his face completely blushed.
Walnut, you loser.
Look at my stream. Probably
over there like, this is way too lewd.
No. Look at my stream.
Look at your stream.
This is what happens. You went for a walnut and you're getting pounded by Phoenix.
It's a walnut spirit left his body.
Walnut's dead.
You know it'll help out better.
I'm not saying anything.
Cool down.
Yeah, I already did take a lap earlier. It has like 16 more minutes. Doing that. Or 12 minutes.
But, I mean, this should help.
Rockin' Stone!
Rockin' Stone!
I haven't played that game in a hot fucking minute.
It's a good one.
And also,
Mayor, you want to play Rockin' Stone with me and Moth at some point?
Oh god.
Yes!
Name the hydrate stretch.
Name a time and a place, and I'll be here.
Okay, I'm good.
2 minutes from now, I'm joking.
Now, okay.
No, I'm joking.
Eat my lamps!
I need the lamps!
Don't eat the lamps. Eat the bread. Eat the walnut bread.
No, that's Phoenix's job!
No, he just cooks it.
Hey, Phoenix is being very generous and sharing his walnut with everyone.
No.
He's sharing all the walnuts!
No.
Wait, what?
Remove the extra loaf. What the fuck?
What?
Huh?
It is
are we supposed to compare it to the top? So there is, but we can't see some of them though.
Thank you, Circuit. I will drink and stretch.
The question is that
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There's 10 loaves on the bottom, and there's 9 on the top.
I think that loaf with
congratulations,
the double is extra.
I think so.
So, like this,
Hold on.
So one of the pieces... No, I think that one might be the berry one.
Yeah.
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 The bottom one, because you can, if you look close, you can kind of see like a hint of purple.
We can see four of the orangey lemony ones. And we can see three of the berries. So...
Some of them have different kinds of slash marks.
Yeah, so there's five berries and there's four oranges.
They do
there's
have
five
slashy
berries.
Marks.
Yeah, because two of them are hidden.
One, two, three.
But
four,
there's no guarantee that those are
five?
Berries.
True. Well, that's the thing is because there's
okay,
nine.
So the four slashy could be the one that's
know.
On the top right. The four slashy plain one. No, the four slashy plain one. Because there's always at least three slashes, and that double bread doesn't have three slashes.
But that one right by the three slashy, you can only see two slashes, so that could be the double one.
How are we supposed to know?
No. Well, maybe.
Yeah. Like the four
that
slashy could
thick.
Be...
Hey, stop that.
You want me to just hit submit? Because it's only asking to remove the extra.
It.
It was
your
the
logic was shot.
That was the wrong look. Take a closer look at the picture on the upper screen and try again.
Look how politely the knight is sitting.
He's just politely waiting.
He's just chilling.
So dainty.
All right.
I organized the bread like this.
We lost.
Who freaking knows why Maya thought this was a good idea?
So,
look, tell everybody you're not straight without telling everybody you're not straight.
What?
Ew, straight. Because
the bread is crooked and it's not straight, get it?
Okay, so... so all the slashes are different.
Yeah, that's why you gotta compare the pictures. That's why we're trying to reconstruct it.
That's why we have to look closely.
Because they all have different slashy marks and stuff. So we gotta
that
try
has
to...
two.
Well, yeah, that one is under. That one's underneath the the top. You see at the top right where the orange is showing, but it's underneath the purple one. I think that's the double one.
Yeah, it could be the double one.
I think it's that orange one. That orange one closest to the basket, because there's not an orange one that has the weird V like that.
It's
not that's on the side of the V.
Wait, no. Yeah, there's one that's on this. The opposite end from the orange, but not one that's on the same end as the orange.
And the opposite one is like two loaves over, so I think it's that one.
Yeah, that's the wrong that's the wrong bread.
See what you think of this.
Ha ha!
As
you'd expect from a gentleman in training.
You found it. That's using your loaf.
Yeah. Now quit loafing.
No, I'm gonna loaf more.
That's exactly how they were before. All we did was remove a loaf. Right. What do you mean that's what they were before?
Maya?
That's a terrible way to organize it.
Perfect! Oh, that's exactly how they were before. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks. You really saved my bacon.
Don't you mean your walnuts?
Mm-mm. Nope.
No, those are cooked.
No, I'm pretty sure there's more walnuts.
How many clones of walnut did you make there?
What?
How many clones of walnut did you make?
I don't know. How many hairs did I manage to pluck from his head?
So why does Mare have clones of me?
Because he had to make walnut bread somehow.
Look, if we can't get wild, we have to get domesticated or farmed. Farmed walnut is just how it's going to have to be, okay?
Mm-hmm.
As long as they're free range, it's fine.
Yeah, it's not like we keep them in a cage or anything.
Yeah. Grass-fed walnut.
Self, make sure to change out the cages.
Yeah. Walnut's just sitting there silently like, I hate this so much.
The natural environment is... We just have a mock airship
bread,
that they kind of wander around in. It's fine.
All that, you good?
I hate all of you.
You said
very economical.
English?
Mm-hmm.
What's that? And where have I
one
heard that before?
At least 5 walnut bread each. Mm-hmm. Hey, Maya, the boss is back.
just in time for some freshly baked walnut bread.
Jesus Christ.
All right, Walnut, this is you.
Why is that me?
You're the one with walnuts in your bakery.
Yeah.
Okay, let me get... Hello, everyone. Just as I was wondering what the commotion was all about, I see you're back, Espella.
Mrs. Patty, you sound deeper than I remember. Welcome home, Aunt Patty.
Were Maya and Phoenix doing the proper job of minding the shop while I was gone?
No, they were pounding a walnut.
Jesus freaking Christ!
Good night, Spade.
Good night, Spade. Good night, Spade.
Of course we did!
Phoenix?
Oh. Phoenix?
Naturally, Phoenix. You can count on us.
I swear you're about to do a Markiplier impression for Miss Patty. Lovely, my name is Markiplier. They may be calling her boss, but she seems like such a warm and friendly person. That's the wrong voice. She seems like such a lovely person.
She says so, and she has a heartwarming smile, too.
Such flattery. You were trying to make me blush. By the way, Spella, are these two gentlemen customers of ours?
These two are friends of mine. They kindly helped me out once in the past. I was so happy to see them again. I invited them here.
Pleased to meet you, madam. My name is Herschel Layton, but you can call me Daddy.
And I am... and I am Luke Trenton?
Triton.
The professor's apprentice.
No relation.
You know, like you a Triton. Call
oh, is that so? It seems Espella is indebted to you both, so it's certainly a pleasure to meet both of you. As a thank you for helping me help Espella, please feel free to stay as long as you like. We just happen to have an empty room that you are welcome to use if you wish.
It's congratulations, bitch boy, you don't need to sleep on the floor.
No, I'm still sleeping on the floor.
Yeah, you sleep on the floor. You get the broom closet.
Oh, yes. I imagine you both must be feeling hungry. No. Would you like some walnut
no.
bread?
No.
Freshly pounded, I mean baked.
Oh, my God. Well, actually, I'm a little more than peckish. I'm actually not hungry at all.
Yeah, we're just gonna stuff
peckish means hungry, boy.
Oh, you don't say. Well, in that case, let me offer you something special. Walnut. Nope, it's not gonna be walnut bread, I can tell you that. My very own creation.
Super walnut bread.
Aha, wonderful. And that face baked on the surface. It's a masterpiece.
That's one of my exes.
It's actually a meat pie. Man, that joke is gonna stick. It better not stick.
Priest?
Yes, I am proud of it. I used a secret technique to make it extra fluffy.
Oh, damn. Making
that seems like fluffy? A full body of bread.
Only the best for our special guest, special walnut bread.
Winky face.
This is horrible. This is horrible.
Boy, try the line again.
Say it again.
This is horrible.
Say it again.
This is great.
I thought you'd like
so
it.
That was that so hard.
That I am here. Maya?
Still, we Captain? Don't have the whole lot else to offer. Only walnut bread.
My God.
Oh, shit. Patty kiss. Well,
all it takes is one bad day.
Only bread.
Walnut's becoming the joke.
Only
bread.
Only bread.
Only flans?
I mean...
No, only
flans.
Only
bread.
Walnuts only.
My
only
God.
Walnuts. All it takes is one bad bread.
Hey, Phoenix, stop
Espella,
talking to chat.
Shouldn't you show our guest to the room? Let's just forget the bread.
I can't forget the walnut bread, though.
Forget the bread.
Dana.
Yes. Dun, dun.
Yes. I heard Xena.
Yes.
I mean...
What is it? Mako?
The red text. You were forgetting. Yeah. The red text. Xena.
No. I did
Xena got it. Xena got it.
Yeah. She did that as soon as I said Xena. And then she said what?
Phoenix Strike, I swear to God. What is happening?
Mr. Layton, Luke, let's go upstairs now.
Huh? What's going on?
Don't ask, don't
Just
tell.
Trust me. Come on.
Only bread. You two really expect to become a full-fledged... Any half-brick attitude, never mind, because I cannot read fast enough.
I think the point is just that she's going to really yell at them now.
Yeah.
Yeah, no. I couldn't...
Take more pride in the bread.
I didn't change the text at all.
Yeah, no, I figured it was automatic. I didn't expect that.
I'm sorry, she's usually... So kind in general.
Circuit, was that a breadstick pun?
About
what?
What?
Circuit made a comment in Walnut's chat that said, "Man, that joke is really gonna stick." And I was wondering if it was a breadstick pun.
No, I think he's just saying it's gonna stick, which I hope it does. Yeah. It's not a particularly good bit.
One bad bread.
It's not a good bit, I'll be honest. not my favorite bit.
No. Not a bit.
I thought it was really great hearing about how Walnut was getting pounded.
I think it shows how dedicated she is to her craft. She gets angry over also, bread.
Also, Mako, Circuit claims he claims all puns is intentional.
As you should.
I guess it must be fun to live in such a lively place, though.
Yes. It is. Thanks to them that I enjoy living here as much as I do. Mrs. Eclair is always so cheerful and kind to me. And Maya and Mr. Wright are so energetic. Maya especially. Just, like, sweat drops. Maya especially energetic.
Oh, yeah. It's certainly an interesting group, particularly those two. But Espella, what about your family?
I am...
What about those motherfuckers?
It's a bit complicated.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to pry.
What have I told you, boy?
Cat. Meow! Go ahead, Mako.
Oh, it's Eve.
What's the matter, Eve? Are you hungry? Sorry, it's my cat. It must be supper time.
I see. Please, go ahead. Don't mind us. You can give the leftover food to the boy.
I'm hungry. I haven't eaten in 2 days.
Yep.
That's you can't you tell time.
You can't read a watch.
You can't read. How do you expect to read a watch?
The cat plushie. Oh, never mind. Yeet the plushie out the window. There's a bird. Bird.
Bird
on the window. Bird.
Bird is the word. It's coming for the walnuts.
Espella, get out of the way. Get out of the way, Espella. There's something way more important behind you.
Hi, Espella. So Espella has a pet cat. Its name is Eve, huh?
Yeah.
A finely groomed black cat, I must say. I'm sure Espella takes excellent care of it. That's it. That's all you have to say about her cat.
Okay. bird.
Not how pretty her kitty is. Or
that's
anything.
Such a cute cat. So well behaved and clever, too.
Thank you. Eve is a real friend.
Unlike you guys.
Unlike everyone around me. I think I'm surrounded by assholes.
Onwards, assholes!
Oh, I'm sorry to have kept you waiting. Are you? Mr. Layton, you wanted to ask me something, didn't you? What was it you wanted to know?
Marry me, would you? Well, there are a few things. I said nothing.
Are we making a walnut cake?
No. We're not moving on to walnut cake.
Yeah, I think so.
I don't know. Walnut cake.
Next line. It may take a little while. If you can spare the time, I can send the bitch boy out and we can speak in private.
Yes, of course. Anything I can do to help.
Oh, all right, yikes.
Boy. You heard him.
Anything?
Yeah. You heard him.
Thank you, Espella. Bitch boy, if you please.
Not.
Well then. First off.
Boy, get out.
What I want to ask Espella about is... after we separated in London, or Espella's memory?
Secret third option.
Secret third option. Will you marry me?
I'm sorry.
Could you tell us again what happened? Between the time that we were separated in London and you're returning to Labyrinthia.
Big stretch.
Well, the moaning does tell a deep story. You said you can't clearly recall what happened to you, is that right? Please tell me you couldn't detect the drugs.
When I came to, I was back here in Labyrinthia.
Oh, thank goodness.
I can remember everything up until I boarded that cargo ship. But after that, I just can't seem to remember how I got back here. It seems the town folk didn't even notice that I'd been away. I almost thought the whole thing must have been a dream. Until the two of you appeared in here, in Labyrinthia. Yeah, Labyrinthia.
In a labyrinth dream.
Can I just say, so Espella, is that what Americans look like and that's what British people look like?
Yes.
Obviously. You don't know... that they're actually performing Shakespeare.
You've never seen a British person before, Walnut. Come on.
No, I haven't. Fun fact.
Well, but now you have.
In actuality, split colony of England.
Damn.
So.
You know what they don't look like? They don't look like dreaming after French, that's for sure. Just joking. What is with us with the burning Paris and the French jokes? Yes, indeed. It all really did happen.
I was going after Notre Dame.
You came to my office.
We had wine.
And then the witch came for you. Right before I came for you.
Oh, yikes. So that doesn't mean the witch brought Espella back to Labyrinthia.
What was that other part I heard you talking about? Before the witch?
Slip of the tongue. Nothing to be concerned
about. Well, I suppose so, but... why was I in London in the first place?
Beats the fuck out of me!
That's what we're doing with the woman, though.
Why did I meet two gentlemen? And why was the witch after me? I just can't seem to remember why.
Say, why was I in London? It clearly wasn't to to enjoy the scenery.
Hold on.
Definitely not the weather.
Let me get my bottle of remembrance to smash. on someone's head. Mm.
The one that's right there, so.
No. Why?
Don't worry. On the walnut bread.
No. At this point, it's more so. Mayor, you said you had, like, half a brain cell?
Am I gonna not have any brain cells? Yay!
No, doing this will make you have 100.
No, I don't want 100 brain cells. That'll make me think. Whoa. Hit walnut instead.
Too late. You've been hit.
People like to think.
I don't want to think. I'll be clueless.
What do you mean sign up for this? I haven't had anything to do in, like, forever. What do you mean this is what I signed up for?
No, this is what
you wanted Phoenix
for.
Instead of
you said Lunar.
I know what I said.
Espella, you and Carbine were running away from the witches,
not you
weren't
not
you?
Doing lines.
I didn't hear what you said. I just heard my name.
I don't mean me.
Do you mean to say that you don't remember being in London with Carmina?
Champagne took you with him and tried to escape from this town.
Remind. Took me with him and tried to escape? I'm sorry. I do have a vague memory of Chandelier, but... why was I in London? I just can't seem to remember.
And also, what the hell is a London?
It's just like Paris. Nobody knows.
What I want to ask Espella about is...
Hold on, let me get you this axe, Marco. Here's your axe.
Do you remember this letter, Espella?
A letter?
Yes.
Keep thinking.
Wow, my brain can't. Candlewick gave you this letter and instructed you to bring it to me. You followed his advice and brought it to me in my office. Alone, in the middle of the night.
Can I take a closer look at it?
Yes, of course. My brain decided to die.
No, you're good.
It's okay. It happens to everything.
Anything.
I don't remember the letter, but this writing does look somewhat familiar. I do have a feeling that there was someone there next to me.
That person was Carlos.
Oh.
Espella, are you all right?
I think I remember. I remember Charlie.
It's getting farther and farther away.
That's the joke.
Really?
You're right. I do know him. I definitely know Charles.
There it is.
Sherry was here in this town. In fact, he was in this very shop.
In this shop, Espella?
But according to townsfolk, they've never even heard of him.
Yes. Yes, that's right. What they say contradicts what I remember. That's why I'm finding it so difficult to trust my own memories.
Please, don't let that deter you. We'd be grateful to hear what you know as they continue to gaslight you about Chadwick.
Mm-hmm.
What I want to ask Estelle about is what she can recall. Please, do let us know what you can recall.
According to my memory, Candy was working here in this bakery.
Eh? But there's already two workers in the shop, right? Mr. Wright and Maya.
Those two have also been working here, making bread for some time now. Or at least, I'm quite sure that must be the case. Mrs. Eclair and anyone else you ask around here would soon tell you so. That's why I put no faith in my memory.
This difference in perception is certainly intriguing, though it is likely you're being gaslit. And the fact that Charles worked here is somewhat curious. I repeated Charles, damn.
Do you think all the townsfolk could just be pretending not to know? I mean, maybe Charmander really was here, and they're acting like they don't remember. After all, he did mention in that letter that he wrote that he escaped from Labyrinthia. How about we go ask a few people in town?
No, Luke. I don't think that's a good idea. As you are no doubt aware by now, a single word out of place can be enough to bring the knights against us, little bitch boy.
Not only that, but I cannot believe that Mrs. Eclair would pretend not to know. She's always so straight with people. She'd never two-face.
I see.
What'd you do with Harvey? Perhaps
the numbers, Mason.
Thankful that she.
Where's Harvey?
I remember someone named Harvey.
I think he was trying to go for a mayor or something. Yes, of course. You're right, of course, Professor.
I'm always right. By the way, in that letter, Cantaloupe claimed that this town held a mysterious secret.
Red text. Oh. Red text.
He implied that he wanted me to solve Labyrinthia's mystery. Do you have any idea what that mystery could be?
Labyrinthia's mystery. I'm sorry, but I never suspected that this town holds any secrets.
Then what might it have been that Crabapple was investigating?
What was Harvey investigating? I think I know what it might be. One time, Henry asked me this.
It's not even the sea anymore, and I love it.
Why is it that whatever's written by the storyteller in the Historia Labyrinthia always becomes fact? If that puzzle can be solved, then we will unravel the mystery of Labyrinthia, he said.
So John didn't believe what was written must have always come true either.
Well, I'm not sure, but...
But what?
It's only natural that... that what's written in that book must come true. And it's hard for me to believe that both you... and Anakin could doubt this.
He hates sand. Well, speaking for myself, I can't just believe it so easily.
You're not allowed to speak for yourself, Luke.
Sorry.
Nevertheless,
I'm out of line again.
To the people of Labyrinthia, it appears to be a matter of
get the
common sense. Which is why those knights treated us with such suspicion. Definitely not.
Objection! Can you repeat the question? I couldn't hear you over the knives.
That's true, but...
Are you saying that in your London, there's no story?
Well, there are certainly none of that come true as the Historia Labyrinthia does.
Hmm.
In the world as we know it, such a notion is inconceivable.
As I suspected.
Circuit, we will not run out of names.
Wick is from the same London as you two. So I suppose it makes perfect sense that you should all think in that way.
Incidentally, what action did Circuit take after he came to suspect the story?
He stole mine, god dang it!
Wrong button. Well, Mayor often visited the archive.
My the god. Great archive?
Every time they say Carmine, the video gets faster.
I mean, you could do it while all of us are just butchering the name. God.
My god.
What's the name again?
Can you repeat the question? I couldn't hear you over the knives.
We're butchering the name with knives.
We truly are.
A little bit.
Espana.
Yes, that's where all the volumes of the story are kept.
You mean to say all previous volumes too?
Yes. Every volume of the story so far. All of them.
I see. In other words, he wanted to confirm the authenticity of the story.
But Professor, surely he wouldn't be in trouble with the witches just for looking at some books. Excuse me. Sorry about that.
I recall in the letter he sent to me, he wrote, I realized the town held a mysterious secret. Thank you for the hydrate, Walnut. And decided to get to the bottom.
Dee-dee-doo.
Thanks, Sam. Sure, I don't get a hydrate. I get a thing a lot.
You get what you deserve. Plus, you never have any water anyway.
But before I
could, you can stretch and hydrate as well. Oh god, I spilled the water.
I believe that was it. Which probably means it wasn't just ordinary books he was investigating. It's quite likely that the books had something to do with the witches. Feckin' bitches.
Oh, here, so you mean that Walnut came close to unraveling that Rebius mystery?
God.
Oh, so close.
And therefore became the witch's target, is what you are suggesting.
I believe that would be highly probable.
But why did the witches...
Espella, have there been other stories involving witches before this?
Ah, yes. There have been many stories about them. All of these stories are also being kept in the Great Archive.
What I want to ask Espella about is the witch's story.
Man, I feel really bad for Marin Lunar.
Yeah, well.
Stories yep, about as soon as I switch over to Phoenix, he gets no lines.
Here, yep.
Or the townsfolk.
Not yet.
I'm sure he'll get a lot of lines, though.
Did you finish? I couldn't hear.
Yeah, sorry about that.
For the townsfolk. So why is it deemed necessary to keep such stories in the Great Archive?
Easy. So we can all have the books in one location, so in case a fire happens... they this are is a an great important idea. Source of information for the Inquisition.
No one expects the Spanish Inquisition.
The prime objective is to capture witches and protect the people of the town.
So you're saying that in order to fight the witches, it is essential to read about them and learn their ways?
Yes, that is
sounds
right.
Sounds like something a witch would say.
Stories involving the witches are under the authority of the Order of the Knights. And the Order of the Knights was established to protect the town of Labyrinthia. Roll credits.
That's it.
It's storytelling.
End of game. Hey, Rabbit. Welcome in to voice actor story time.
The Knights and the Inquisition. They are the ones who govern this town.
Yo.
How's your day going, Rabbit?
The entire fate of Labyrinthia is decided by the creator, otherwise known as the storyteller. I could easily tell you who the storyteller is, but my memories.
True.
That personage is the weaver of all life in Labyrinthia, including the current horrifying story involving the actions of a witch.
All brick.
And falls to the Order of the Knights.
Nice.
To protect the townsfolk from such events. The Knights not only protect people, but also act as the storyteller's guard. And finally, the Inquisition. The Spanish Inquisition.
Specifically,
the French. It's the French Inquisition.
Responsible for trying the witches in the witches' court.
It's true, Rabbit. There was a whole long thing about it.
Mm-hmm. Can we talk about the walnut bread?
The walnut bread.
Oh my god.
That's right.
Look, the Spanish Inquisition is only
here. That is
the
manner in which this town is managed and order is maintained through walnut bread.
No! No, we're done with the bit.
No! The bit will never die!
This is what's known as a callback walnut.
Yeah, this is a callback.
It was the Order
or
of Knights
giving
peace during the parade that we saw.
Stick out legs.
That's right. The storyteller holds these parades from time to time.
Makes them feel important.
The problem.
The town folk, the story that'll determine their fate. From that time onwards.
The reason I'm frustrated is because I'm writing down like the
time
times.
Involved a witch, mm-hmm. Which explains why the knights were on such high alert. I wonder what
too much
spells
walnut bread.
Will
too
be
high.
Time.
It was the walnut bread.
If only
they were a little bloated.
Look.
Mm-hmm. Just a moment, Isabella. What was it that you just said?
Just the banana bread of this group now.
Do you mean to say
banana
that
walnut bread?
There's a book about magic?
Magic?
Objection! You're right.
That is the worst objection in history. I find the defendant guilty. Objection! You're right.
Hold on. Say it again.
The judge. I find the defendant guilty.
Objection!
Then the judge is just like,
bailiff, whack his pee-pee.
God.
We're all a little bananas. It's true. We're all a little bananas. Except for Walnut, he's a little nutty.
Yes, there is. In the Great Archive, it describes all the spells that provide the witches with their wicked power. It's a special book. Used by the Knights of the Inquisition to aid them in their investigation.
That's it! That must have been what Chaos was so interested in. He was investigating the witch's
indeed,
power.
Indeed, Rabbit.
Of course, it's possible that he came upon a secret that he shouldn't have known.
Ah, and that's why the witches attacked him?
Indeed, Luke. They may well be the reason. The story, so respected by the people and the witches, whom they fear. There could be a certain secret connecting these two in some way.
And I have nothing to do with it. Allegedly.
Yep. Allegedly.
I thought that was the rock.
Can you
What's
smell?
What's Wayne Johnson doing here?
Well,
thank you.
You know, I gotta I gotta teach other witches, you know. So, Professor Layton, you have a good night. I'm gonna go teach witches magic.
You can never smell. That's a lie.
It's fine. It seems we now know where to begin with our investigation.
So you'll be visiting the Great Archive?
Yes, indeed. The book about magic that resides there may well provide a valuable clue toward unraveling the mysterious of Labyrinthia.
Circuit, that's a horrible superpower. What's your superpower? I can smell extremely well.
I think what you mean is extremely bad.
We better get going with our investigation straight away, right, Professor? It is horrible.
Don't tell me what to do, bitch boy. Absolutely, Luke. We must solve this puzzle for Clarence's sake, as well as for our own.
Mr. Layton. Please. Please take me along with you.
No.
I'm not sure that's wise. Women are kind of a curse where we come from.
My God.
It might put you in more than a little trouble. And us, too. It's likely that Colin. We haven't done Colin yet.
There you go.
It's likely that Colin's investigations are what led him to being pursued by the witches. And if that's the case, the path we tread may well be fraught with danger. Not somewhere a little girl like you should be.
Even so, I would really like to help you. Talking with both of you like this, I too have come to believe that there must have been a secret to this town, that Carl didn't die for nothing. I want to help you find the truth.
Well, Isabella, I suppose that settles it.
That did not take much.
From here on in, let's all do our very best to solve the mystery together. Man. Not that you'll be much
help. Together.
I'm the professor's apprentice, so if that's anything you just...
my lips!
So if there's anything you need to know, just ask. Didn't ask, Luke.
Delicious lamps, thank you.
No. My lamps.
Might eat your fucking lamps.
Thank you, Luke. I'll be sure to do that. How do lamps taste, by the way?
Delicious.
Then, without any further ado, let's follow in Karaoke's footsteps and visit the Great Archive.
Bring the goddamn lamps!
Make the damn lamps!
I'm quite certain that's where the clues are waiting to be found.
Gonna.
Yes. Let's go.
Yes.
I'd say it's Lunar and Mare fighting downstairs about eating lamps.
I'm afraid you have to stay here until I get back.
Sounds good. I'm out of here.
Fuck this shit, I'm out. Don't forget this necklace.
Oh.
It's probably important, yo.
I almost forgot it.
My witch pendant. That gives me my witch powers.
That's what keeps your powers sealed.
Yeah, switch, slay. Slay, witch.
It's very old. I can't even remember how old I was when I was wearing it. Right.
I'm sorry. Maybe you shouldn't let the witch cook.
Shall we leave for the Great Archive now? So I can get other witches to hunt you down.
No, Maka. All the knights just storm into like a witch's hut. Witch's hut. She's like cooking, and this one of the knights like, hang on, hey, let her cook.
No.
Then they take her outside and light her in a fire and go, hang on, nope, let her cook.
Let her cook.
You rise.
So the knights bust in on the witch who's cooking. One of them says, hold on, let her cook. One of them smells. I think that's walnut bread.
Oh my god.
That's how it always is. Oh, it's too late now. Now it's back to Escala.
Oh, so sorry.
Sorry, I laughed and pressed the button.
No, you're good.
Yes, I'm taking Mr. Layton and Luke to see the great archive.
The grand
at least
line.
For the rest of stream that, circuit. At least for the rest of stream.
We're going to the grand line.
My god.
One Piece is real!
Y'all made me fall out of my bed.
Good, good, good.
Wait,
is that so? Well, you might want to hurry. It looks like it might rain at any time. Yes. Yes.
Stop nutting all over the stream, Captain.
I'm not doing anything. I'm just saying Walnut. He's gonna say he's gonna read Patty.
Patty.
I was trying to read. You're the one that interrupted me halfway through me reading it.
Couldn't hear you.
Is that so? Well, you might want to hurry. It looks like it might rain at any time. Oh, yes, that reminds me.
Walnut cookies.
Cookies, not walnut cookies. We don't need that. We already have Rabbit walnut bread.
They landed on bread. Walnut bread, that is.
God. Could you get me something while you're out? Just on your way back should be fine. No.
More walnuts!
No.
Phoenix used all mine.
Because he made sure that walnut bread took a pounding.
Of course. What can I get for you?
Get some goat's milk from Mary. I forgot to get some while I was in the market. At the market.
Okay, I'll drop around Mary's farm on the way back.
Would you? There's a milk bucket ready round the back.
My brain heard milk button.
There is a milk button around the back.
It calls the milkman.
Milk button, you say?
Naturally, our bakery uses only the finest goat's milk for our milk walnut loaf.
You don't need to add walnut in there. It's milk
walnut.
Look,
you don't need to milk walnut, okay?
No, I'm no, like,
I'm making walnut milk now?
No, we are not going there.
They need to calm down. Calm
walnut
down.
Bread is fine. I will be fine with walnut bread. We are not going to milking walnut.
We're not going to get walnut milk? Bread.
No, we're not going there.
Oh, come on.
No.
Yes.
God.
Look at the line.
I know, I saw it. That's why I said
it's so fluffy and white. It's so delicious. Oh my God.
No, fluffy.
Gonna milk the walnuts now.
No.
All right, Luke.
He's so fucking done with us.
Luke?
Oh, really, Reggie?
Luke?
Sorry, my mom messaged me saying I was being too loud.
Oh.
Sorry.
What's the big... Oh.
Yeah, I gotta write down this time as well.
Okay.
Cool. Sounds great.
Let's be certain to try some later.
Oh.
I am totally not up for that.
Try again. God,
I am totally up for that.
Thank you.
He said, laughing behind the pain.
Yeah. Talk to Phoenix. Oh. Talk to Phoenix. Oh.
Hold on.
Go back in and talk to Phoenix.
Lunar.
Oh boy. So I came across as rude earlier.
Please, pay it no thought.
It's that sometimes I get carried away pounding the dough like that.
Yes, that's completely understandable. I also get carried away pounding.
It looks... Well, it was kind of surprising to hear a big thump like that, even if you were just kneading the dough.
It basically writes itself.
And then when you said, take that, my heart nearly stopped.
Yo.
When I bake great bread, I guess I just feel the need to present it to the customer like that.
Damn.
My God.
Damn, Phoenix. Lunar. Tag, you're Layton.
You're tag, I'm Layton?
Yeah, you're now
tag,
Professor
you're Layton.
It's quiet
tag
time.
Oh, it's quiet time?
Almost, but not quite. I need a break from doing voice lines for a minute.
Okie dokie.
My head is starting to do a pounding.
So it has a real pounding as hard as Phoenix did to the walnut bread.
I was gonna say,
not quite that hard, but it's
this VOD is going right in the garbage bin.
Right in the trash, where it belongs.
Meanwhile, I'm like,
no,
hey, Walnut,
that's my home.
You can't put it in the trash. That's where all the viral things come from.
My God. All right, well, you're Professor Layton for right now.
I was waiting for you guys to finish talking.
Sorry. This VOD is the cream of a crop. No, it's not, Circuit. I don't know what VOD you're watching. It's not this one.
This is absolutely great. I love this.
From the look of things, we should be safe to explore a little more before making our way to the Great Archive.
Hey, look. Captain?
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 Oh, did you two see the latest story?
Hey, Bob. We're playing
this
voice actor today.
Particular.
Wait.
When you say latest, am I to assume that these parades are held on a regular basis?
You mean you don't know that? People these days, no one knows a thing like that street urchin. Never mind, I'm a forgiving sort. I suppose I should fill the gaps in your knowledge with walnut bread.
No.
Somebody posted in general, whoa, walnut bread be upon ye.
Wait, what?
look at regular general. Reggie just posted, whoa, walnut bread be upon ye.
Wait, hang on. I actually do have a picture. 1 second. There we go.
Hold on.
Xenon. Jesus Christ.
With the maid on looking.
Oh, just like, my God, that poor walnut bread.
Jesus Christ.
Wait.
No, I don't want to, actually. Fun fact. No!
Just give it a crack.
Meanwhile, I just posted the Phoenix right, just punching. That's how the walnut bread gets pounded.
Cracking them walnuts.
Bread and center. Bread mode VTuber win. No.
Turns into walnut
bread. What you're saying is we need 500 subscribers at the same time. Later. That is when he'll do walnut bread.
I've got a doodle request.
No.
Oh, we're making walnut bread? Or is it Phoenix Wright pounding walnut bread?
Walnut bread at 500 concurrent subscribers.
Well, no. I have like a bunch of like animated slots. All I want is like just a picture of like just basic bread with like four ears and goggles on it, and it's just spinning in a circle. As like an anim, as an emo.
Give me my lamps.
I'm gonna eat them.
Don't eat the lumps. Wait,
hey, walnuts are getting to the bit already, guys.
Listen, I just
accepted it.
Well, no, it's just that is an animated thing. It seems very funny to me.
You know, funny as well. Animated emote of dough being pounded.
No, not that one.
Good job.
Yes.
I am fine with walnut being bread. Nothing with pounding dough.
Walnut, you know what you should do?
No.
You should play I Am Bread.
No. Yes. You do not want to see me play I Am Bread. I will lose
it. I do
want to
see you play I Am Bread because we're talking about walnut bread.
Thank you for stretching Hydrate. Mako, if you buy me I Am Bread, I will play it on stream. I'm not doing it regularly. Do not buy me bread. That is a joke.
Do it. I will give the first person $20 if they actually give him that. And then he has to do it.
Too late. Thank you for the stretch and hydrate. My God.
Anyway. So, Captain.
Captain?
The storyteller appears in a parade before the common people whenever he writes a new story. It would be no overstatement to say that I spend every waking day looking forward to the stories that he provides.
Mister writes the best story and gives people their best lives when he writes about
it. Man, all right.
He just broke his glasses. Oh, never mind then.
It was witches.
What are you saying? Logic. That only happens to be the story this time. Usually the storyteller writes the most wonderful stories. Like walnut bread.
Nope.
That's why I thought he would give us a wonderful chapter today, too.
Alas, we were duped. We were bamboozled. We were hoodwinked.
We were lied to.
We were lied to.
Alan.
Captain.
Alan.
Captain.
Captain.
It's still you, Captain.
Give me a second.
One.
Never!
Instead, I found myself caught up in the crowd. My glasses were broke, and I was bitten by a dog.
How?
Town. Every cloud has a silver lining, so they say.
Don't feel down. Don't feel down, you say.
How fucking dare you?
Do I look like I'm feeling down? Bah! No way I am feeling down.
I'm actually quite happy today.
Nice.
Hey. I read the thing.
Xena.
Xena.
Xena's dead. Along with Xena.
I think.
Hail to the meme queen.
Mm-hmm. Hail to the queen, baby.
And a wonderful described. Walnut bread. My day is on the up and up.
Oh my god. Walnut loaf.
Sort of by walnut bread.
Sorry, I have to do a quick stop and to the bathroom.
You're fine.
You're good. Mm-hmm. You're good.
Okie dokie.
No, you guys remember when we were joking about me having a P.O. box and like people are sending millions of walnuts? People are just going to send freaking walnut bread now if I open a P.O. Yeah. box.
Probably. Yeah. That's the new thing. It's going to be hilarious.
Yes,
you
it will.
Run out of walnut bread.
I'll have infinite food. I don't have to pay for food anymore. I have infinite walnut bread.
Yeah, yeah. Everybody just make walnut bread.
Pin in general. Oh, what is... Now I got to go look at what the pin is.
I think it's just the whole conversation of the bread thing.
They pin, whoa, walnut bread be upon thee. Thanks, Circuit. That really need to be pinned in Moth's chat.
Well,
yeah.
That's never going anywhere now. That's your life now, Xena, walnut. I hope you enjoy it.
Advance, cool.
And don't forget, if anything, we must remember to post it in Walnut's server as well.
Don't post on my server. Wait, is it posted on my server? There's no way.
Wait, it's not. Let me get in the server. I want to be in the server too.
Let's say it's on my Twitch. You're welcome, boss.
Do not feed bread to the ducks. Bad.
Feed the mare.
Yeah, feed
just
me.
Don't tell Wolfie or Birdis or.
No walnut.
Okay, so here's the thing. Birdis actually feeds me.
I do not think I am friends.
Wolfie does not.
I don't think I'm friends with you on
fine.
Discord.
You're not a mod here, so we can feed you.
Yes.
Hold on. I'm adding Mare as a mod.
Don't add Mare as a mod.
Do you not feed your mods, mine. Xena?
What? I don't want to.
Does indeed have a server.
Anyway.
I'll send a link in my channel. 1 second.
Captain?
Hey, I read it.
Oh.
We've been waiting for you, Xena. I even said.
Wait, where is it?
New captain.
Oh, sorrow. Part of me is such sweet sorrow.
There is my Discord, if anyone was wanting to join.
And I just immediately just post walnuts.
You know what I just realized? Literally, one thing that I have on my channel that I don't really use a lot, because I don't have too many of them, is I have a sub, like, only chat, and I call them cooks.
Wow.
Wah, wah.
And the reason I call them cooks is I'm like, hey, let them cook.
Wow.
Well, long.
Now we know what they're cooking.
Mm-hmm.
Walnut bread.
They're cooking walnut bread.
My God.
Exactly.
I'm never serving walnut bread on my airship.
That's all
he serves on his airship.
That is not all I serve on my airship. You're it's not all right, having.
Don't say it.
It's the only thing the cooks could keep up with to make.
No.
The demand
look,
is
it's
high.
Not like walnut has an infinite supply of nut or anything.
I don't.
Somebody literally, else joined in on the chaos.
I say, literally, there's nothing about, literally nothing about like me is has to do anything with walnuts. It's just my name.
Give the bread,
yes,
please.
Yes, walnut has a server.
Give bread.
If you want to join my server, I sense.
Was the line red?
Yeah. No, wait, no.
No, because everyone was talking, so I didn't say nothing.
Lunar, you gotta speak up, man.
Look, I don't want to just be rude and talk over everyone. You're having a pleasant conversation. It seems rude.
Interrupt the chaos.
Do it.
Fine. Shut up, Mockle.
Ma, how dare you? Oh, man, I can't believe Buff would do that. Man, Ma is kind of rude today.
I only do it in chest. I would never do it in real. I don't yell at
you. Man, Ma is so mean, guys. Man.
It's time.
It is. What do you mean it is time? Apparently it's snack time, by the sound of it.
Snack time.
It seems that all stories are born equal.
I feed Mare chips.
Ah, I see.
And a pizza.
Hell yeah. I get pizza and
pizza?
Chips.
What kind of pizza?
Is it pineapple pizza?
Pepperoni.
Hell yeah.
Pepperoni? It should have pineapple on it. Hold on, let me just... Pineapple in chat.
Suddenly, pineapples.
There we go.
Don't pineapples worry. To pay respects.
You can get pineapples via the spatial pineapples. You're welcome.
Hold the pineapple.
I'm just gonna just post pineapples in all chats.
That's fine.
Pineapple pizza. Right. Long man.
Pony boy, close your eyes.
So, pineapple pizza!
Pony boy does not like the pineapple pizza. It's the only way I can get him to stop licking stuff.
There you go. Pineapple pizza.
You're Mayor with the first right time right chat right. In Mako's chat.
Wait, oh yeah, what? I've been lurking this entire time.
So, Lunar,
and I've already gotten like
as you should be.
Is that you need to roll around in pineapple pizza.
That seems to be the way of it. I just need to like get a can, open up several. I'm gonna go buy some fresh pineapples. Gonna just like cut them open, roll around on them, then roll around in some pizza sauce so I taste like pineapple pizza. And then Pony Boy will never lick me again.
By the way, did you say the line?
I did.
Yes, you did.
Okay.
Why do I feel like this person's character might have something to do with it? I was about to say, all right, who's Luke?
That's a fair point, Circuit. So maybe we won't do that.
And Xena, I have an idea. Yeah.
We should talk to the knight, right?
We should talk to the captain, yes. Now, Xena, you know, also, freaking Mayor on Xena's Twitch looks even better on Mako's head. Now, duck.
I have a duck.
It's perfect.
Right?
And Xena, before we continue, hear me out.
Oh,
what if we...
Right, continue the thought.
What if we?
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 I'm sorry.
What if we?
Oh, double or nothing, Buckshot Roulette!
He's trying to escape the bread. That is exactly right, Circuit.
Well, no.
That does mean we gotta pause.
Smoking the reefer.
On to Buckshot. Where hopefully there'll be less talks of walnut bread.
You realize bringing it up will only make us do it more now, right?
All right, we're going to be taking shots of walnut bread now.
Taking shots of walnut bread? That is horrible.
Shots.
So, what we're actually doing...
Shots of walnut bread? Can I at least have some honey butter with that shit?
Hold on.
Let me
also add something real quick.
Walnut bread and honey butter.
Can it be like the, what is it, Texas Roadhouse cinnamon honey butter?
Texas Roadhouse.
Yeah.
Nice, Reggie. Nice.
It's gonna be toasted.
The guy from Fast Food Secrets Club has the recipe from Texas Roadhouse for their butter.
Hell yeah.
Now you can make it at home.
Sweet.
I'm gonna move that up. Where is... There. No.
Walnut roulette, here we come.
Walnut roulette. All
right, walnut roulette.
Yep, this is it.
So properties. Wait,
added a hyperlink to the recipe for walnut bread I used in the pin. You did not pin a recipe for walnut bread.
Why not? Walnut bread's good.
Yeah, walnut bread is really good. Like how my first post is just walnuts.
It's just walnuts. But no.
Does anybody know somebody that calls them a momkey?
Momkey?
Momkey. Because they like banana bread.
Mm-mm.
And bananas. You're a momkey.
Banana!
Reject monkey. Return to walnut.
Mm.
Yeah, we eat the lamps. Eat
the lamps. Banana bread.
I actually didn't even do it.
It looks like you got a beating. Just slur saying, everybody.
Are you going to leave it that big for the entire buckshot?
I mean,
also, it's not showing in Discord, Xena, so we can't actually see it.
Yeah.
I'm trying to. Is that better?
I have to wait for it to shrink. Yeah, that looks better.
You guys know body shots as a concept?
What? Yeah.
I know what they are, yeah.
I don't think so.
Walnut shots.
We're taking walnut shots? We're taking walnut shots.
Jesus Christ. Walnut roulette, here I come. In fact, I have to talk to Mr. Squeakers about a thing now because I have an idea. I love being a coder. Oh, no.
No, what?
I'm the waiver.
Sign the Weaver.
Sign the waiver. All right, Peter.
Oh, you couldn't have named it Walnut?
No.
Or is it too big?
No, it's six letters.
No.
But no, peanut is good because peanut gallery.
That's true.
That's what I was going with.
Could have gone with bread or W bread.
I said we're not doing the switch like when we normally play.
This is all Xena.
This is all Xena.
All Xena. Her redeem, her we go, will help. Her show.
I said we will help count, and that's about it. Two, three.
But do we have to help correctly?
No. Second shell is blank.
It wouldn't mess her up anyway, so I'm not even gonna bother.
2, 3. Okay, so the fourth shell is blank.
It's like he's trying to escape the bread.
So fast.
Okay, and shoot myself.
Yep. Exactly. Blank. Ooh. 1, 2, 3.
Well, after a bad start.
The second shell.
I sure
blank.
Am. Yep, the third shell is blank.
Second shell.
No, it's the third one.
Second shell is blank.
I'm aware.
Not anymore, it's not.
Say now it's gonna be 1, 2. Because that's now alive. True. Just smoke.
Bum, 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 bum.
Blank. Ooh, nice. Pretty solid.
You thought.
Sure did.
Oh, I found something for Walnut.
No, you didn't.
I did.
No, you didn't.
1-1. 2-3.
Walnut chicken.
Perfect for
yams.
1 to 2 people when baked in a 2 mini loaf pans. Eat one now and store one for later. Freezes very well, tastes well when.
Tastes well when.
It just, that's when it cut off. It literally cut off.
Really? For me, it says tastes best when tight.
Interesting.
And it said what shell was live?
Fifth? The fourth.
I have no idea. I haven't been paying attention.
Okay.
Fourth is live.
So that's
I
two.
I was not looking.
I was harassing Walnut. Three.
Four is live.
Four.
Nice.
And last is blank.
What do you mean everyone can write in my rules channel? There's no way.
I want to fix that then.
Man.
Yeah, you can.
Oop, did it just?
I can. Okay.
Wait, how? I can't change it. I can only make it private.
You gotta go into permissions.
Oop, yeah.
Hold on.
What is happening?
Permission.
I don't know the screen with gray.
Oh, there it is.
Rule and walnut bread.
Permissions for you on it.
Same thing with roles. You can also type in roles as well.
See, oh God.
Walnut, are you the owner of your server or are you just a member?
No, I am. I had someone else make it for me and it didn't work out.
Didn't do
well.
A good job. Tell them to do better.
I don't know how to do a Discord. Hang on. You're view fine. Channel.
All right. No one should have.
Thank you.
The ability.
Like I don't know how to mess with that stuff. Like literally, so, I know nothing about Discord. I was looking at all that
I'm
stuff.
Gonna
like I cannot
move over my stream so you can see it. My Discord. Mm-hmm. So what you do is you see this.
I cannot see.
Edit channel.
I got a gray screen.
Yep,
mm-hmm. I have a gray screen as well.
No, on stream, on my stream.
Oh, on your actual stream, on okay, yeah.
Oh.
Yes. Okay. Yeah, I am looking.
No, little gear.
Yeah, no, I clicked on that gear and I saw like the entire thing. I saw it change. It's just I don't know what each of those do. No. I was in the process of reading those.
Public and view, not manage. People can't send messages, embed links, attach files. Reactions, fine.
Okay.
Stickers, no.
I mean, we can go in depth.
Let them read.
If you need it.
Not send.
And go through each of them.
Say again?
There you go.
We can always go in depth with you about it.
Yeah, that'll definitely be an off stream thing. Anyway. We might do that later. Like I said, I didn't make my channel and I don't know anything about making a channel, Discord thing.
So. Okay. Two knives, 4-4.
Nice. What were the rounds?
4-4.
6 shells live. What we got?
Blank. Nothing.
4-3. Four, two.
I should have just done what I wanted. Mm-hmm. Invert it. Use the knife.
4-1.
Oh, right. I lose here.
Oh my god. Four live rounds.
It was all blank. And then all live.
Mm-hmm.
Yup.
Cool. And then we have to make it to double or nothing. Thus is the channel redeem.
Yep.
Also, Xena, I just happen to think your like performance stuff is at the top right. Are you wanting that there?
I don't care.
Okay. So you know. W bread. God.
Walnut bread.
Welcome.
Walnut bread.
You know, you gotta pound the walnut bread pretty well.
Nope.
Ah.
1-1.
I know exactly what to do in this situation.
Fair. Second shell's live. Damn.
Comes back like, how could this happen to me?
I made my mistakes.
Inverts it, shoots himself.
If only.
You know, today, did not expect the word of the day was going to be walnut bread. Fair enough.
Yeah, no,
I didn't expect it either.
No, I really didn't. Fun fact.
Second
show.
Show
is live.
As I thought.
Just for the extra FU.
It's not like I'm gonna keep items.
True.
Seems super hard.
Yep. Very. Double damaged.
It's blank. I could have, should have, would have.
Mm-hmm. Get another opportunity to double damage.
I can always check to see the first round as well.
Mm-hmm.
I have a magnifying glass.
Yep. Sure do. Four shell is blank.
So that means this first shell should be
live. Alive. Yep.
What do you think? Second one blank?
I think the second one might be blank because I think it's gonna be like blank in lives.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Final round.
Final round.
Three, two, two.
Two, two.
I'm going to use my magnifying glass.
Fair.
Good call.
2-1.
This is live.
1-1. Cool.
As a thought.
You don't give him an inch.
Why give him a turn?
Exactly.
Handcuffs.
Please, handcuffs. Please, please, please. Oh.
He's got it.
1-1.
But this is handcuffs. Easy.
Yeah, this is free. Now, if only it had handcuffs.
Or a saw.
Or a saw, yep.
But no matter what, I win.
Yep. Very true. You have a magnifying glass and an inverter. No handcuffs? Oh man, whatever will we do?
2-3.
2-3.
All right, so yeah, ma'am.
You're in, you out.
We do this.
Fair.
We do this.
There we go.
And it's
done. Double or nothing.
There's double or nothing.
Mm-hmm. We did it. Or Xena did it, not we. Now we go back to Professor Layton.
Mm-hmm. Congratulations, Walnut Bread.
My God.
So, you heard it here. Walnut Bread won.
Yay, Walnut Bread!
God.
Thought he could escape the walnut shot.
I figured this would be like a good thing to like kind of... No.
Nutshot? Yes, that works.
I figured that'd be like a good thing to kind of calm down because we're all getting pretty...
pretty loud.
Pretty loud. Pretty... Yeah, just loud overall. So I figured that'd be a good thing
to kind of quiet down. Let's agree to disagree on that one.
Okay.
But...
Never mind then.
Also, may I just say... Wow, that looks like walnut bread.
That's taking a pounding.
So if anyone visits St. Louis, there is a hamburger joint around here that their challenge burger is called the Pounder.
Oh,
almost of forgot. Course.
And if you finish eating the whole thing with all the fries, you get your
walnuts might be extinct in the future. For all I know, a circuit. Who can say?
So.
How many walnut breads 40k can buy?
And you go there. Sorry, stream ended, everyone.
Oh. Oh no.
Could you stop licking the adhesive off of this?
Do it.
Alright.
Do it for the vine.
Discord.
He is doing it for himself.
And soundboard ready.
Soundboard ready.
All right.
Ten of all.
Blue.
Wow.
This is so ducking great right now.
It looks Blue. Impressive from a distance, but now we're here up close. It's huge.
That's what she said.
Oh my god.
You should have known that was going to be said.
Oh yeah, I did. I was just hoping it wouldn't. Just looking up at this makes my neck ache. Thank you for the hydrating stretch.
I'm good.
I'm good.
Stretch. Must have taken considerable time and manpower to erect a building of this size.
Yeah.
Shut up,
Mary. I don't know much about erecting buildings.
This building has become something of a town symbol.
Thank you, Mr. Squeakers.
Huh? Hey, look at the roof over there.
Sir.
It looks like it suffered a considerable fire damage at some point. This is, was there a major fire somewhere?
Ha 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 ha! Oh, wait.
I think that was the wrong one.
Ah, that was...
the whole way.
Is this that one lady?
Oh, I think it is. I don't know. If not, someone takes, but I've been listening to you for a while, and I must say, you two are really strange.
Oh, nope. It's Mare.
That's Mare.
Captain.
Oh, it's you.
Wait.
Sorry, that was Luke.
No, you're fine. I was watching somebody make clay art.
Fair.
Sir, off the desk.
That roof has been like that for some time. It's certainly nothing new.
Really?
All right, with you. Could you tell us a little about it? Or we're going to have to sit and listen to a lecture about how we don't ever know anything and you just play the pronoun game before you finally just tell us what we want.
Mm-hmm. You two never cease to amaze me with your incredible lack of knowledge.
Option number two.
Had enough walnut bread. Walnut bread.
Yes, because I don't have any walnut bread. It's because that's how much of an asshole I am. I need fresh walnut bread. Well, I guess it couldn't hurt to tell you that damage is from the legendary fire. Xena, do the thing.
Xena, the thing.
Hold on, let me do the thing.
My god.
I don't know, I think I probably triggered my acute bronchitis.
Legendary fire.
Yes, long ago there was a huge fire that engulfed almost this entire town. The damage there occurred at that time. You can still see other traces of the fire around the town, too. Here and there, of course.
The entire town was engulfed in a huge fire?
That's what I fucking said. All of the townsfolk know about it. You're probably the only ones that don't.
Don't mind the boy. He's a terrible listener.
Yeah, no kidding.
Thank you for filling us in. That certainly cleared up a few things.
No problem. It so happens I had nothing better to do because I had no fresh walnut bread. It wasn't such a bad way to kill time. Anyway, I'll see you around.
No walnut bread.
I'm gonna go see if there's walnut bread.
I got some walnut bread at home that was freshly beaten.
Oh, yes. Let me fresh quack in delight.
For your pleasure.
To think
sir,
even a building of this,
that.
This size
stop
could be affected
that.
By fire.
Stop it.
If the fire spread through the town, really, really must have been legendary.
You're certainly right about Luke. Or right about that, Luke.
Certainly right about Luke.
Mm-hmm.
He not that bad.
He's a street urchin.
Tom's not right about
he Luke. Is a street urchin. Spella, is something the matter?
Oh. No. Nothing at all. Shall we make our way inside?
No. Oh, we have Lady.
It just won't do. It's completely unacceptable.
What's unacceptable?
In fact, we're not having walnut bread right now.
There's no one must find it the Inquisitor Bono. And yet, every time, it's that woman who gets to stand alongside the Stowy Tower. It's so unfair.
You mean the woman who is distributing the story to the crowd? Is that right?
To be honest, I found her a little scary.
I'm sure it's all some plan of hers. I just feel sorry for my poor Zakums. Oh, if only I could get closer, I could offer my support.
For a little Zaxnack. Well, it'd certainly be difficult to get close with that bustling crowd all around. Perhaps even dangerous.
I'd fly.
Huh?
I could float down beside him from one of the fluffy clouds in the sky.
Oh okay, my bye. God, what the fuck?
Impromptu what puzzle as we try to save the crazy lady.
We're flying. We're flying.
There's this Link story.
We're flying.
Navigate Luke through the clouds to help him find the professor. Jump through the hole in the clouds. We'll drop Luke down a below level. Otherwise, jumping on the two fluffy clouds will send him flying up to the next level. Interesting.
Send Luke flying.
Hello.
And he fell to his death. Yep.
And then he died. The end.
Boing.
Hey, he's ascended to heaven.
Well, that helped.
Is it heaven if there's no walnut bread there?
My God.
Valid. The Duckwood demands bread, please.
So, walnut, you gonna give the duck bread?
No, it's, not particularly.
Okay. But it's walnut bread. It's healthy for me.
It's cake. That's all it is. It's cake. Let the bread.
Yes. Give the duck some bread and cake, please. Cake. I'm doing a heckin' starve.
Mm-hmm. Give ducks
and I'll
cake.
Just bite walnut.
I say then perish.
Immediately over. Just starts biting walnut.
No, do not. I'll kick you off my airship.
Bailiff, whack his pee-pee.
God.
White walnut's leg. Num, num, num,
no,
num.
Get off. No, stop.
Yum, 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 yum.
Stop. No.
Give me bread.
Stop. Stop. Go
give
away.
Give me bread.
No.
Give. Bite,
I don't
bite,
have
bite,
bread.
Pick, 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 pick,
stop,
pick,
stop,
pick, pick,
stop.
Pick, pick,
yes, this is the right answer.
Pick, pick, stop pick, trying pick, to pick, pick, rub
no,
walnut.
No, I think you need to go back the other way.
Pick.
There's no
pick,
back.
Pick.
I think I solved it correctly.
This is my answer. Fuck you, buddy.
Oh, we were only one away from 666.
Aw, man.
Oh, see, no.
Immediately starts pecking walnut again. Peck,
stop.
Peck, 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 peck,
I gotta... Sorry, guys. I gotta restart the game.
So, too bad you haven't saved recently.
Oh, I dropped my phone.
Oh, just it looks like someone just redeemed save.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
I wonder who it could have been.
It wasn't me, because I didn't do it that time.
I don't know.
I'm making a joke.
It would normally be me. Male person. The male whale.
Pick.
Stop.
But.
Uh-oh. Not good. What should I do?
What's the matter? Is there something troubling you, madam?
Punt the duck.
Oh, yes. Something certainly is troubling me. I mean, today's scary story is just so frightening. I may be afraid, but I have to do it. I have to finish my delivery.
Hey, why not? Guess what?
Such a good lettuce. I have to go over the marks. Really is a world. Right, I can help by delivering it to you for you. No. It is alright. After all, it is my job. And anyway, you look so busy right now yourself.
Zeta, I was gonna say, do you want someone else to do the male person, or do you want to talk to yourself?
I mean, it'd be nice if someone else did the male person. Because it just sounds like I'm...
Yeah, it just sounds like you're talking to yourself. Exactly, that's why I was suggesting it. Does anyone want to play the male?
Yeah, why not? I'll do male.
Alright.
Well, a little, but we should always help each other out in times of need.
I'm okay. Don't worry about me. I've got it covered. Right. Off. I can do this. I can deliver them all. The letters, I mean. Nothing can stop the Labyrinthia Courier. I'm off!
Mm-hmm. She just broke the sonic barrier.
Ah, she's gone. It really was in a hurry, wasn't she?
Mach 7, even.
Sorry, I'm like, why is no one calling for help?
Peck. But is she really alright? She seemed a bit flustered. Stop pecking my leg.
I think she's just very busy.
I am bleeding on the floor just off screen!
Come on, let's head to the Great Archive.
You're never getting your mail on time again! I hate you all!
That's like Austin Powers. Oh my god, a shark! Oh, it's fine. It's fine, guys. I'm fine.
But no, never mind.
Duck has a peck fetish.
Wow, these are all books crammed in here from floor to the ceiling.
Really remarkable. You know what books are, right, Luke?
No, not particularly.
Don't worry about it. Are all these books stories? Quotation marks?
Yes, they are. All of them. That said, these were all written by the storyteller.
And those over there, those are fan fiction.
We don't read those.
We don't read those. It's a forbidden land.
Excuse me, beg your pardon. Look out, gangway! I've got... Don't worry! The base of cake!
Dewey is in the Dewey Decimal System?
Yes. Yep.
Phew! Told you! No problem.
Then immediately drops them.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry to startle you, folks. Didn't think there was anyone here.
Moth, do you want someone else to do Dewey? Because I think there's going to be a lot of dialogue between these two.
Yeah, that's probably fair.
Michael?
Sorry to startle you, folk. I didn't think there was anyone there. Dewey's a little snooty.
That's all right. Lucky that you didn't drop any books.
Damn right, it's lucky.
I don't think I've ever seen anyone carry so many books at once. Aren't they heavy?
These are light novels.
They are light novels. Xena?
Sorry, Lucy wants attention.
I see.
I love books, so I feel like a mother carrying her baby.
I always stack my babies one on top of the other.
If you love books too, why not carry a few with me? Not that I need your help or anything.
In London, we burn books to keep warm.
That's his face again. I do love books, but I don't think I could carry that many.
You obviously don't understand the true enjoyment of books. Embracing books, being buried in books, the feel of books, the smell of books, listening to the sound of the pages turning, gazing at books piled high, being surrounded by books and playing with them, that's how to enjoy books.
Playing with them?
I'm not sure I totally agree.
Man, this guy has
a weird thing for books.
He's got a book fetish. Leave him alone. Stop shaming. That voice. That's a speller, isn't it? Oh, no, don't let her see me. Oh, here we go again. Oh.
Lena.
Please remain calm. You wouldn't want to drop those books.
Just leave it to me. See, I'll under control. Don't let the heathen touch the books.
Sorry, I didn't mean to startle you like that.
The fuck you didn't?
Dewey, we've come here to find a book about magic.
Magic? I should have known. That is, never mind. Witch, never mind. Well, if it's magic that you're interested in, then might I suggest the Grand Grimoire?
That's where the really spicy fanfics are written.
Oh, boy.
Grand
Those
Grimoire,
are the,
you say?
X-rated ones.
We'd like to borrow that book, if we may.
Well, you need Miss Mystere's permission. Are you sure you want to borrow it?
Absolutely. We're very interested in magic. And fanfics.
Friends of Aspella's interested in magic. I should have known. The fecking witch. So these two must also be... Whoa! Sorry. No.
Just the constant.
I'm losing it. No, Estella, you...
Silence in the library. The great archive was founded for those in the noble pursuit of knowledge. I must ask you to be a little quieter, please. Dewey, as a budding librarian, I would have thought you would have known better.
Michael?
Dewey?
I'm sorry, Miss Mystere. But these people say they want to borrow the Grand Grimoire.
The hell they can.
Did you say the Grand Grimoire?
Well, we'll take the pretty okay grimoire if it's allowed.
Mayor, do you want to...
Guess who just got a text
Estella
being too loud?
Cantabella. You, of all people, must know this.
Text him back, tell him to get earplugs.
The Grand Grimoire. It is an important piece of literature which can only be viewed by learned persons of significant status. It's not like I can just give my permission to whoever asks for it, you know. I understand
that. Solve this puzzle.
I'm sorry, but rules cannot be changed.
Your quest is all mine. That book could prove indispensable for my investigations into magic.
And you are? Excuse me, but may I ask your name?
Big Fat Pile of Nunya. I'm Hershel Layton. Most people call me the Professor. Big Professor of D. I'm investigating this town. You could say I'm a traveler, so to speak.
a traveler, I'm afraid I've never come across such a profession.
People don't travel.
I suppose we can return to that later.
They can't get out of the fucking city, they can't.
My name is Verdero Mystery. I am a librarian as well as a curator of a great archive. And I am therefore responsible for all pieces of work here, including the Grand Grimoire. I'm afraid that no matter what your profession or who you are, it is beyond my authority to lend you the Grand Grimoire. It is simply against the rules.
The rules? Can't you make an exception for us?
Yes, madam. I'm one of five people that can read in all of London, and probably this town, too. Also, Luke, shut up. Leave this to me. I can understand you are unable to show this book to just anyone. However, I am not just anyone. As you yourself said just a moment ago, the Great Archive was founded for those in the noble pursuit of knowledge. And I am currently very much in the pursuit of knowledge regarding magic. Perhaps you would consider letting me at least peruse the Grand Grimoire?
Only London persons of significant status, and in particular, inquisitors, are permitted to refer to the Grand Grimoire.
Inquisitors?
Well, time for Inquisitor Layton.
Those who administer justice in this town, Knights of Wisdom, as they are known.
Ah, boy, fetch my black coat.
Only somebody with equal status to that of an inquisitor or the same level of wisdom would qualify.
So you're saying if I solve a basic puzzle, I'll be allowed to look at it?
You certainly are persistent, gentlemen. Very well. Let's see what you make of a trial.
Oh, good. I'm
this
right.
This trial has been used in the past to test the ability of aspiring inquisitors. If you are able to clear this trial, then I will acknowledge that your wisdom matches that of an inquisitor. If you can achieve this, then a curator of the great, then as curator of the great archive, I will lend you that book.
Lend it. This should be a snap. And by all means, do begin.
You certainly have some confidence. Let's see if you can live up to it. Do you think you can pass this trial at which so many hopefuls have stumbled? See what you can do with this.
Two plus two equals.
Also, I happen to think, so are we just not wanted anymore?
Hmm?
We were wanted by, like, the knights. They were trying to arrest us, and then Espella took us off and, like, hit us in the... They just forgot. Cool.
My guess is since this world seems to exist within the book, and therefore things just happen a certain way, they got pissed at us because we were fouling up the narrative, and... Once we're out of the way, probably things just kind of reset and went back and we don't exist anymore as far as they're concerned.
Hmm.
You know, they kept talking about we didn't quite fit. That's my guess.
You can only move within the direction of the clock hands.
Okay, so we gotta need to make a path.
So, the clocks will rotate 90 degrees each time you walk.
Ah. I see. So you kind of got to plan ahead.
And it shows it's going clockwise.
90 degrees clockwise every time we move. So we've got to definitely think ahead.
Look, one of them actually turns counterclockwise.
Oh, well, never mind. It's just they turn 90 degrees. Into the direction of the clock hands. Find your way through the clock maze. Righto, this should be fun.
All right, we got this.
Okay.
Let's see. Okay, so we'll move over. And then it looks like we can only move to the right. And then we'll be able to move down. Or to the right and then down.
Right, down.
We'll go right. It'll only let us turn back again. Because if we move right, then...
Go down.
Well, is the clock to our right, was it moving clockwise or counterclockwise?
This one?
Yeah, that one.
It was moving counterclockwise. Goes up. Or clockwise, I mean.
So
yeah, it's
going to
be up and towards
right,
us.
So we'll, okay, that, if we can get on that spot, that might be... That's not bad. I was thinking if we can't get on that gold one, we'll be at a dead end because we can't
It's a dead
move.
End.
Yeah, but I mean, from there, we could move to the right or even back down again, maybe.
I don't think we can get on the golden things, I think, is what we're saying.
Hmm.
Now go right.
Oh, yep, I was going to say, now go right. We could have gone down.
Go right.
Oh, that'll work. Yeah, go there. Well, yeah, up, or we could
go right. Oh. And go, yeah, then right.
Yep, then we can go right again, and then we can go
then
down.
Right.
Then we can
then
go
down. Then down.
And down.
If we go down, it's going to point the opposite direction.
Yeah, it's going to go that
yeah.
way.
We might have to make
yeah,
a little circle, but we can still do it.
Step right again.
Yeah. And then go right again and over.
Oh, there you go. Yeah. Nice. That was a really hard puzzle, so I'm glad we have the intelligence of an Inquisitor now.
Mm-hmm. Only an
well,
Inquisitor.
Like I said, Leighton's one of five people in all of London that can read. Probably.
He's one of five people in all of London.
All of London town.
Give me 1 second.
Okay.
Whoa. Who's lazy? Mayor's now a duck. Yep. They changed their little icon. Yeah. Circuit just realized you went from chicken to duck.
It's been that way for a little bit.
Yeah.
I didn't say he was.
I was making bread jokes for a hot minute. Like, give me bread, walnut bread.
Everyone was making bread jokes.
Hey, Big Evil. Sorry. I was focused, so I didn't see you there. But hello, Big Evil. How you
Hello,
doing?
Big Evil.
Hi, Big Evil.
I was distracted. We were solving puzzles and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Voice acting.
Attempting to.
What could be,
Well, also making bread jokes. Walnut bread jokes.
Controls yep. real quick,
because for being loud, even though
battery's dead on controller.
Whatever. My existence in this place.
Good, just got my Baker. First joint tablet.
Hello.
Well, we're just we're doing some voice acting. We're just the whole little group of us. We're just being silly little voice actors, and it's been silly.
Just a silly little duck.
Silly little duck, silly little moth, silly little bard, silly little fox, and silly little mako cat.
Immediately, peck, 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 peck.
So I'd say pretty good. How are you liking your first drawing tablet so far, Big Evil?
Yes, answer us.
No. Where's my controls?
Tell the Inquisition how you feel.
If I don't fucking sit up, then I'm definitely gonna, like, nod off.
Does it not configure current game? Audio, debug, cheats, figure.
Dina broke it.
Controls, there. All right. B.
Oh god, I spilled the water.
Yeah, actually, I'm out of water, so I'm gonna have to go get that water. We'll see you doing this. I'll be right back.
Okay, thank you, Circuit.
Cancel, configure, controls. Yeah. So U A D W S L R this was on 3DS, so I'll leave that like that. There we go. How can this be? That hardly seemed a challenge for you.
You don't know the half of it.
Who are you? And how did you know? How did you do that so effortlessly?
Oh, importantly, who designed this? Third grader? There's one thing of which I am certain. And that is that every puzzle has an answer. So, do I qualify?
No.
That was only the first test.
Not so fast. You really believe that my permission could be attained as easily as that? That was no more than a preliminary trial to separate from the wheat from the chaff.
Who got gold? She's a jade stuck up on me, I guess.
The real trial, even a man of your caliber should be finding this a challenge.
We're up to fourth grade. All right.
This trial will have your eyes rolling and your head spinning.
Shocked, dull, shocked expression.
I'm back.
Dewey?
Well, Circuit, you're getting into the cold, but we're getting into the hot. So, Miss I envy Sarah, you. I much prefer cold than hot.
Excited before.
Silence.
Your food.
Quiet, Dewey.
Sorry.
Hi back, I'm Circuit. Nice to meet you, Circuit.
I assume it's safe to predict that this will not be quite so simple.
Ahem. This will put an end to
another
that
puzzle?
Overconfidence. Prepare to lose your mind.
I hope you're not making this up on the fly.
This mind-bending puzzle.
Do the same thing, but with a time limit.
Yep.
Yep. I was half joking. Oh. Oh, three times the speed. So they move.
Mm-hmm.
So that'd be.
They move.
Whatever. They go.
270.
Yeah, 270. So, but the point is, yeah, they move three places instead of just one.
Yep.
So that means if we move right, it'll be pointed right. Which we have to move right.
Funny miscalculation, and it's game over. I do hope you don't mind.
So yeah, we have a certain amount of moves. I bet.
No, we can't undo.
I think she's just being dramatic.
So, where would we go?
Let's see. I would say go right, because we'll be able to go right again. And then we can go right again. Then there, we can go... Let's see. Down, because I'd say go right, so we can go down.
Then down.
And then right. Or left. That boned us.
And that's it.
So.
I mean, there's right, any points for that, though.
So go we right.
We probably did.
I'm guessing we did. Maybe we go down this time?
Down.
Yep, and then left, mm-hmm. And then down. Then down. Obviously down. Crap, nope, that was not.
So.
Right, so go right.
That.
Can't go down because that's just a dead end again. So we gotta go right. Gotta go right.
Can't gotta go down. Right.
Yep. Gotta go down. Gotta go left.
Gotta go.
But yeah, that's just what we did before.
Yeah, it's the same thing.
That's what we did the first time.
Okay.
Down.
So I guess down?
No, because it's gonna be a dead end.
Well, are we sure we can't go on those things?
Oh.
See?
No, we're not sure.
No, now we can't move.
That's what I know. Yeah, no, we can go any direction we want.
We can, can't we? Huh. I just thought that those were dead ends. Just made the most sense.
Nope. That's and up and down and out.
Nice.
Excellent.
See,
work.
That's why how I figured those things would work on the other one. They're just empty spaces, so you can just sit on them and go any way you want.
725.
Yoot. Yoot woot.
How? My mind-bending puzzle. You didn't lose your mind. On the contrary, you found the solution.
Look into my face and you'll see the face of your puzzle god.
Impossible. Oh no, my glasses. My book. Don't look. Don't look at me.
Oh no, she's hot.
My glasses. What? Let me put them on. Just a moment.
I definitely was not messing with my goggles in that moment.
That's better. I apologize for a moment. There, I lost my composure. But, to see my trial cleared like that, it seems I underestimated you, Sam.
It was a fascinating puzzle. No more than I expected from the curator of the Great Archive. A little straightforward, though.
Confidence rather disconcerting. I hope someday to have the pleasure of showing you a puzzle that will make those little round eyes of yours spin in your head.
I'm actually dead inside.
But, nevertheless, a promise is a promise. I hereby grant you your permission. The special viewing room containing the Grand Grimoire is located on the first floor. As I'm sure you're already aware, that book is of unparalleled importance. By no means may it be treated with anything but the utmost care.
Of course, Miss mm-hmm. Mystery. Thank you for granting me permission.
Well then, shall we proceed to the special viewing room? Wink, wink.
I'll view anything you're willing to show me, ma'am.
I shall have to accompany you, since the room is locked.
Locks are just another form of puzzle. Boy, hit the picks.
You did it, Professor. You cleared both trials in one fell swoop.
That was amazing, Mr. Layton. It's well known that Miss Mystery is an avid collector of puzzles. And I've heard that the puzzles she presents are always very difficult to solve.
I see. Well, as you understand, the puzzles are the only thing that keep me alive. Without the puzzles, the boy and I, we wouldn't make it. Cold dead stare. The puzzles are the only thing that give me meaning in life. Anyway, sorry. Little bit of a episode there. Sorry. I hope I didn't say anything too disturbing. So, there are collectors of puzzles in this place, too.
What do you mean?
Oh, nothing important. Not like it's a drug or anything. Right then. No use in waiting around. Let's go and take a look at the Grand Grimoire.
Right, you are, Professor. I forgot who I was for a second.
I long for death.
Yes, Bella. No worries.
Oh my god. Is there going to be coins in here?
I would imagine. Mm-hmm.
Saw some pop-up.
Oh la la. Oh la la, indeed, Big Evil. Winky face.
There
it is.
Coin. Just a few more and I can finally retire. The Mushroom Kingdom social security is not something you can rely on.
What?
Sparkle. Coin.
Taking a look. Sounds good, sir.
Now then. once you're done with that, take another lap. This has got to
be the most amount of take laps I've ever done to this stream.
That sounds like a challenge.
Maybe for the stretch and hydrate as well.
Oh god, I spilled
the water. That is okay.
Where's the third coin?
I'm good. Okay.
Have you checked? There's third coin. Yep.
It said there's a third.
There it is.
There it is, on the banner, of course.
Actually.
Now then.
Remember, boy, two spaces behind and to the left.
This is the special viewing room.
No eating in the library.
I'm sure a gentleman such as yourself will understand. But seeing as this is a special room, not to open to the general public, after all, they say some of people will just come into a library and eat.
Turns around.
Opens book, crunching noises.
Do you want to answer? Because this is
and you know, we can't allow any food to be caught in the...
No, just like mouthful of food.
They gotta be clean. And, you know...
No food in the library. It's fine.
I must insist that you all be on your best behavior.
And especially no eating.
And especially no eating in the library.
Right, boy, get out, get in the cage. I'll be with you shortly.
Wow, this room feels so grand and elegant.
Too good for your eyes.
It's my first time in here, too. I must admit, I feel a little nervous.
Certainly does give some indication of the importance of the book being kept here. That book is in the center, must be the Grand Grimoire. Now, the fact that it's the only book in here.
True.
Oh, wait, no. It wasn't mystery, but just Espella in the background going.
Just crunching.
This is eating.
Eating and crunching in the background.
All right.
Coins.
Have you guys ever had somebody CC like someone else on an email?
Huh?
Yes.
Yes.
CC.
I know that happened.
Yes. Carbon copy. Basically, sends a copy of the email to someone else instead of the intended recipient, but alongside of them.
Yep, my dad has done that a few times with me.
These are text messages.
I see.
That's
she doesn't
weird.
Just text me. She texts me and Carl. So that That's if weird. I don't do what she wants, then Carl feels bad.
Mm.
Can I just... Hold on. I'm gonna have to do this.
Objection! It's wizard time, motherfucker! Fireball!
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 It's Fireball. A proper reaction. Oh, and, you know, because we're in a library and everything.
It's wizard time, motherfucker! Fireball!
There's no I in team, but there's five in. I don't care how small the room is, I use cast fireball.
I cast and fireball.
It's
and there's six.
Three.
No, seven yeah, if you three. Add in the library.
Mm-hmm. I don't care how flammable the room is, I cast fireball.
Nice.
Right by her head.
Mm, she was hiding it.
All right. Here's a puzzle.
We get pulled into this book, too.
This is incredible. It's crammed with information about magic.
Boy, you can't read.
Boy, I know you ass can't read.
Boy, I said, boy, you can't reach. Shut the hell up. Stop pretending. You're not fooling. I say you're not fooling anybody, boy.
Do you guys know the picture of the alligator looking at a book?
People say it's the magic used by the witches.
If so, then the magic we saw in London must be in here somewhere, too.
That may be, well be true, Luke. A tome thick of this must surely contain such information.
Finding it is a bit daunting, though.
It's almost as thick as your head, Luke.
Huh? What's this, Professor? This page is different than the others.
Graffiti.
It's almost like it's been torn.
What is this? Defiling a book?
This page isn't about magic at all. Something about it makes me feel uneasy.
Luke, this page. Appears to be addressed to someone, don't you think? That's a sordid love note.
Oh, you mean like a message? Let's read it, Professor.
No, boy, not like a message. What are you, stupid? From a long time ago.
In a galaxy far, far away.
The ancient flame has been locked in an infinite vault of books, waiting for the awakening. It's a very sleepy flame crystal. When the sun and moon, watching over the sage, swap places to show their true form, the door to the past will open.
Ah, shit.
Once a person of Perspicacity, there we go. Thank you, Mako. Has fulfilled the challenge.
What is perspicacity?
I don't really know.
The door will open. The student is ready, the master will be found.
Only a person filled with determination.
Like
Google, show me this guy's balls, please.
God.
I've heard the word, but I don't know its definition offhand.
I've never heard that word before.
Google.
True. Yeah, I got you. I got it.
The quality of having a ready insight into things.
Oh, I see.
So insightful.
Yes.
So someone like Luke.
Someone the opposite of Luke. So it doesn't just keep stating the obvious. This must be the bakery, Luke. Is this the bakery? Do they bake bread in here, sir?
I wonder what they bake in this bakery.
Shut the goddamn hell up, Luke. I swear to the queen and God, I will end you one day. One day I'm just gonna snap, and no puzzle will save you.
Until then,
I will wait for the time of the awakening.
I mean, Dr. Rebotham, sorry.
How dare you?
Set my wake-up call for 7 p.m., and God help you if it's late. That's right, I said p.m. I'm a night person.
What is this?
Shut the hell up, Bobby.
Can this be? Why is this in here? How did something like this get into the Grand Grimoire? It's just not possible. I can't understand it. No one entered the special viewing room before you came here. And whenever someone enters this room, I always accompany them in this way. So that means that the page must have changed at some point, doesn't it?
Spella, what did she just say about eating in here? I am disappointed in you, Spella.
I couldn't help
it. Walnut bread is just so good.
But the walnut bread
is just so good. Bread.
My God.
And that, Luke, is why walnut bread is today's word of the day.
Could that really be possible?
You heard me.
Perhaps with some kind of device.
Or a secret door. Or, I don't know, witch magic?
Tunnel.
Unthinkable.
There could be a secret tunnel.
There is only one key.
Who's ever eaten your mama's hoe?
Without being granted my permission. I assure you. It's true. on my honor as a curator.
But then how could anyone have done this?
Luke, stop hurting. Stop thinking you're hurting yourself. I believe you both know who might be capable of such an act.
Professor Layton, why is Luke's got smoke coming out of his ears?
Don't worry, the boy needs to learn.
Sorry, boy.
Hey, on, let him cook.
Something cooking, all right.
You mean witches, don't you?
You mean my sisters. I mean the witches, don't you?
Witches?
You mean my coven. I mean, witches.
Quiet thinking and contemplation. You don't yet know yet who changed that page.
Sorry, we're gonna
but the more important matter.
I'm getting sick. I have to stop early and then no stream tomorrow.
Okay.
Okie dokie, Mako. You go lay down and feel better.
Yeah, go lay down and feel better.
Walnut. Remember.
Thank you, Mako.
Shout out. Have a good one, Mako.
Good night.
Hope you get better.
I don't know what it is. I just feel sick.
You're good.
Love you guys. Bye.
I hope you didn't catch what I had. Sorry if you did. Bye.
It's probably related to Shark Week, so don't worry about it.
That's probably true too. I'm sorry.
Oh yeah.
So, Mare now takes over all of Mako's.
Yep.
Girls.
Jeez, what is written here?
You have a uwu voice too, right?
Yeah, you have a uwu voice.
That'll do.
What'll do, Mare? What'll do?
The ear lamps for that one.
Don't you touch my goddamn lamps!
Don't touch your goddamn lamps.
Meanwhile,
my lamps, don't touch them.
Meanwhile, Mare is just like to Lunar.
Bailiff, whack his pee-pee.
That's rude, and you should be very ashamed of that.
You're the best of sleeps.
You good, Mare?
I'm a little tired.
Let's see.
Do you want to stop and go to bed?
We could save after dialogue. Mm-hmm. And then
you get the dialogue, call it. Yeah. I say we do that.
I like a plan to me.
Mare's got the eepies.
And I have work tomorrow, so it might be best if I go to bed early.
Fair.
Hurry.
Lunar?
The infinite vault of books mentioned here presumably refers to the Great Archive, which implies there's a secret of some sort hidden within the library.
Professor, what about this part? A person's of precipice? Speaking that of word. That word.
Well, I don't know exactly what it means myself. It's very hard to say. I believe that could be referring to carbine.
Carlos.
Yeah. The bit continues.
He came here regularly to investigate.
Plus, we already used Carlos, I think.
Mm-hmm.
So it's certainly somewhat likely. Which means our next objective is to find the answer that he was looking for.
It's a bit of a spooky message. If we can open this door to the past, then we should surely be one step closer to solving this mystery.
Sorry,
the oldest door in the library.
I just informed the witches that you're learning something you shouldn't. I mean, just a moment, please. I'm the curator here, and I won't be allowing you to investigate anything without my permission.
And how many puzzles will that take?
So you mean we can't investigate?
Not at all.
I don't have an uwu voice. What are you even talking about, Big
that
Evil?
You allow me to accompany you. There should be no doors in this library that I don't know. And even if there's something hidden somewhere, as it suggests by this message, it is my duty as curator to know what that is.
I completely understand, Miss Mystery. We can only benefit from your presence.
Now then, how about we all make our way back to the entrance? Let's think about where this door could be from there.
All right. Nope.
Nope, not almost. Done.
Oh. Come on, dialogue!
Walnut?
Oh, that's me. But Professor, supposing there is a door, that message is such a puzzle in itself. Don't you think it'd be difficult to find?
You may be right. And this library is so large. Finding anything will surely take a good deal of our time.
Okay, well, I hope you weren't trying to post it. I'll assume that was an oopsie. I just thought you were posting a link. No, I think not. You're both missing something here. I believe I may well know what is meant by the words in the message.
Really, Professor?
Did I stutter, boy? Yes. You'll just remember the wording.
We were just there. Please don't.
From a long time ago, blah, 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 so on and so forth, waiting for the awakening. Let's do the whole thing again. Got by a rogue. Forgot. Ah, yes. That's what I figured, Big Evil. The door will open. Don't have a wait. Taking a really good nap.
The door to alchemy will unlock.
Yes.
It only costs an arm and a leg.
Exactly.
Hey.
Well, technically it was a leg. He used the arm to get his brother back.
That's true.
There are books extending all the way up to the ceiling and a key opening doors.
Sorry. I saw L.
Yeah. The key to opening the door is in the sun and moon watching over the sage. Sorry, I just used my dramatic voice there for a moment.
But what could that mean?
There are no windows, so no light can come in from the sun or moon.
Precisely, which means it's not the real sun and moon that are being referred to here. You dumbasses. They are located where they can watch over the sage. In other words, behind. Perhaps you have already realized to whom the sage is referring. Right then. Let's find this sun and moon watching over the sage and open the door.
I think we're clear now. Yep.
That's right. There. Yep.
Right where it left us.
So, menu.
Save. That is also a good Pokemon game.
Oh, saving to file 2.
I never actually finished Moon.
I've never played it.
I finished them both. They were actually pretty good, and then I played the next versions.
Right. So, now... We need the lamps.
Peck.
Rating.
Let's see. Who are we gonna rate? Lunar? Do you have anyone in particular?
I think we should raid Lunar_Mirshan.
Oh, let's see what I got online. Who we got?
Because if not, I got one that I know Mare knows.
Let's see. They'll go with your choice then.
Go what with do you mine?
Got? Yeah, why not?
Lolpop Lilith.
Lil who now?
LOL Pop Lilith.
I was going to say, you could raid the Stutter Boy.
Stutter Boy? Who?
The Stutter Boy. All one word.
Oh, I see. Playing Grand Theft Auto?
Mm-hmm. He's a really sweetheart of a streamer. I go and watch him all the time.
Okay.
Then he's a little... He's a little crazy, guys, but he's pretty awesome.
So, can you spell that? No, I don't think I spelled it right.
It's V-S-T-U... T-T-E-R boy.
B-O-Y.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I got it.
Raid message is gonna be
We solved the puzzles with walnut bread.
My God.
Do not raid my offline channel circuit.
We should. You know, that sounds like a great idea.
No. So
my message is going to be Phoenix Wright gave a pounding to a walnut bread.
Yeah, I'm not doing that one.
I'm just going to do my regular raid message.
You know what?
I hope everybody enjoys Stutter Butter.
And I also thank everyone for coming out today. Even Khan, who left Marco as well. And I also thank you, Mayor, Walnut, and Lunar for being here.
Yeah, no problem.
There's our raid message.
And I have to see what we're going to do next week. We might do Morkborg.
That'd be interesting.
If everyone is able to.
I'd probably be available.
I'm also thinking maybe next week with more Monster Hunter and then Batman. Yeah. I gotta figure out.
Oh God, I can't do more and more.
Already. Bye.
Good night, my lovely little fireflies.
I'll talk off stream. But
go forth. Go forth. Remember, you're awesome. So I hope you had fun. It was a little something different. Lots of chaos. Good times. Happy times.
We are going to
be raiding the Stutter Boy.
He's going to be so fucking good.
It'll be amazing and hilarious. So
to all my lovely crewmates, I appreciate every single one of you. I appreciate all you guys for coming out. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Adios.
Goodbye, fireflies. Bye-bye.